Every year for the past 10 years, the Port of Long Beach has hosted a Woman in Trade Luncheon for young women in Long Beach to learn about all the career opportunities in logistics, and most importantly, meet professional women who can share their personal stories.
I really enjoy getting to talk to the professional women and all the amazing career opportunities. It's really cool.
There's a lot of jobs and a lot of careers that I had no idea existed, and I thought it was really nice to get a perspective from all the women who are working hard for their jobs.
Seeing all these women in male-dominant fields, it really helped calm my doubts about entering the field.
I'm Bonnie Lowenthal.
And I'm Sharon Weissman. Both of us are members of the Long Beach Board of Harbor Commissioners.
And today, we're delighted you're joining us to celebrate our 10th anniversary as we meet some of our incredible past panel speakers and table hosts.
Women who are showing young women in high school and college that there are hundreds of careers that go beyond the work of dock workers who load and unload the vessels that call at the Port of Long Beach.
What makes their stories so inspiring is that they not only talk about their job, but they share how they got started, how they're advancing, and what it's like to be a woman in this industry.
Join us as we share some of those stories now.
I'm responsible for all the Coast Guard operations that span 350 miles of coastline, all the way from the San Luis Obispo County line to the Orange County line offshore to 200 nautical miles.
I am currently a sales representative for NYK line. So basically, the big container ships you see outside, there's all different kinds. And I try to talk to customers and have them use NYK line instead of putting their containers on another carrier.
I do labor relations. And what that means is that I work with a union who represent the longshoremen. Anybody here have longshoremen parents? Woo, yeah, there you go. So I work with the union to help the workers keep cargo moving in the ports of LA and Long Beach.
I started as a logistics manager, or called a train master, just telling all the guys how to build the trains, where the trains are going to go, what customers need to be spotted, so on and so forth. Did that for 5 years, then went into sales and marketing. And then about a year and a couple of months ago, started this job as the port director of business development. So I have all the California ports and the Texas Gulf ports. I'm basically the first liaison between the ports and that port staff.
Well, right now I'm providing oversight for the Gerald Desmond Bridge replacement project. It's a new cable stay bridge that we're building in the Port of Long Beach. And it's the single largest contract that the port has awarded for about $650 million.
As you just heard, the range of jobs is quite astonishing, which makes perfect sense when you realize that right now in Long Beach, 1 in 5 jobs are port-related.
While women make up half the workforce, statistics show that only 35% of them are holding jobs in the goods movement sector. That's why getting our message out to young women is vital to ensure a strong and diverse workforce in the coming years.
Seeing this discrepancy and the need to take action was one of the reasons Susan E. Anderson Wise, a former president of the Board of Harbor Commissioners, started the Women in Trade celebration back in 2011.
Then, like now, one of the key questions these young women have is, what's it like to be a woman in the industry? Here are just a few of their surprising answers.
I think it's 13% women at Cal Maritime. When I first went there, I was really discouraged. I remember orientation week thinking, like, what am I doing here? Like, I'm like the only woman here. Like, I don't feel comfortable here. But you know what? I didn't let that stop me. And 3 years later, I'm right here. And I'm a senior, a few months away from graduating. And I would encourage you all to just never give up.
Well, when I first started at the Port of Los Angeles, there were 2 women that were hired on within a month of each other. And we were the first 2 females ever hired. And I still have the newspaper article in the picture. I keep that, and we still keep in touch.
If you're the only female at a table, that means there is an opportunity. And they can't take anything from you if, when you are talking, that you know what you're talking about.
Challenges in the workplace are to be expected, but how to react and move forward is also key. As a moderator, one of my favorite questions was, what advice would you like to share?
every time you meet someone, take something away from them. So if I meet someone that I think is super professional and I like the way they're wearing their scarf, it's something that I add to my thing, right? If I meet a strong woman and I'm like, oh my gosh, I really like the way she speaks, learn something from every single person that you meet.
Being interested in environmental, being interested in science, I never would have thought about a career in international trade or in this industry. It just wouldn't have occurred to me that there was an opportunity here. But being open to these opportunities has allowed me to advance in my career in a positive direction.
Don't be shy. Being shy can be expensive. And by that, I mean that a lot of times I was very shy to ask questions, to ask for someone for their business card, because I was like, well, what if they don't give it me their business card? But that cost me opportunities.
I always said yes, right? When opportunities were presented, I said, sure, I'll try it. I'll try that too, and I'll try that too.
Inspirational women that you can network with and get them to become your mentors that drive your passion to be into those positions. So please don't let anyone tell you that you have to be this or have to be that. Look at the non-traditional careers like international trade, international relations, and pursue that.
While the panel presentation is central to the event, there's also a unique opportunity for the young women to chat with the professional women who sit at their table.
To facilitate conversation, each table is hosted by a professional woman in the industry who encourages the young women to ask questions and explore why working at the port could be a great fit for them.
These intimate conversations also help students explore even more opportunities as the range of professional women who volunteer their time to host these tables is quite impressive.
And I think the reason they do so is the same for all of us. We want to make a difference in the lives of these young women and show them that there are amazing opportunities for them right here in their own city.
With the Port of Long Beach being one of the largest ports in the world and growing larger every year, it is critical we at the port support educational and career preparation programs in partnership with our high schools, colleges, and port industry partners.
This helps open up the doors to the students, and it's populating the workforce of the future and educating the workforce of the future. And that's really, really important because we are finding shortages of these kinds of jobs and personnel to fill these jobs.
Which is why we ask our partners to join us and host a booth the young women can visit before the luncheon begins.
Giving them another opportunity to make connections and explore ongoing programs and internships with our participating partners.
The feedback every year has been incredibly positive, with everyone attending saying it opened their eyes and gave them specific ideas to pursue.
We know this outreach educational program works, and we're committed to hosting it again as soon as we are able to.
Till then, we want to thank all the professional women and industry partners that have made women in trade possible these past 10 years.
We can't wait to gather together and continue sharing just how many career opportunities are available at the Port of Long Beach.
Thank you for joining us for this special 10th year celebration. Hope to see you soon.
I've talked to so many women and they've just given me more information about what they do on a daily basis, and it's been so helpful.
I met Beverly O'Neill, the former mayor. I met Laura Dowd, and they were so great. They gave me a lot of ideas as to occupations that I can take and major in college. And this is a great experience.
Honestly, some people don't know what career they want to pursue, and this gives them a good idea of what they could probably do. And just in Long Beach, there's so many different options that they can choose from.
I've always been into like graphic art and stuff, so I spoke with some women over there and I got a business card and a possible internship, so that kind of stuck out to me and I was like, okay, cool.
We can look at them as our mentors and they can inspire us because they're just like us and they've gone through the same thing that we've gone through.
The best piece of advice that I think I got today is that you have to empower yourself and you can't wait to be motivated by someone else because you have to go in and do what you want, because if not you, then who?
it makes me feel proud that, you know, us young ladies, we have more options open, more jobs, more opportunities out here in the United States, and that they give us the opportunity to actually see and guide us in many things that they have organized here. So thank you.